On the cover of this month's issue. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're here discussing his career, his highlights. We'd like to talk about you, your career, what you've been up to, and what's coming out in the future. And my first question for you is, how did you get into the entertainment industry, and what's that background been like, and how do you feel about where you're at right now?
I started with my first modeling job. I started in New York when I was 2 months old, and from there I've just been going. I did a lot of modeling New York with Wilhelmina. I was there for 15 years, and I did a bunch of commercials, indie films, shorts, all that kind of stuff. And then I've done a lot of theater as well, and then now I've done 5 movies in the past few months, past year. So, and I feel like I'm in a really good place now. I'm really picking it up, and it's going very well.
That's wonderful. So you said that you started at 2 months old. That means your parents have always been extremely supportive. How do you feel about being an actor in this wild industry? You know, you run into so many different actors, and some parents aren't supportive, and you know, when you run into an actor that their parents are supportive, that's such an uplifting feeling. How has that been for you to have such supportive parents?
It's really been a very, it's been a really nice feeling that I've had the opportunities that have been given to me. I've really had the support of my family, friends, and everybody. It's really an unbelievable feeling.
That's wonderful. So you started off in print, you did a little bit of theater. How did you make the transition from theater into film?
Well, I actually did film into theater and then back to film.
Oh, okay. So you started doing film?
Yeah, I started off doing commercials and some indie films I did in New York. I did 3 indie films in New York before I started, and then I did, during my high school years, I did 7 shows at my high school. And those came out really well, really great productions. And then I switched back into film when I was out of high school.
How did you make that transition?
Just auditioned and went out for it and got right back into it.
Did you ever train at, you know, somewhere?
Yeah, I've done a lot of training. I was with Wees Barron in New York, trained there for a very long time. A whole bunch of places, trained in Miami, I've trained here, a whole bunch of places, Brian Reese, Upright Citizens Brigade, all those kind of places. So.
Wonderful. It seems like all that training and hard work is finally paying off because you are 100 top under 25 years old celebrities. How does that feel?
That's pretty amazing. I don't know, it's a pretty amazing feeling. I'm really happy and really glad that people enjoy what I've done.
And I heard you're ranked at, what, 62?
It's, yeah, I'm 62 out of 100.
That's really exciting. So that must be bringing a lot of positive attention to you right now.
Yeah, a lot of really good stuff is going on. It's so much fun.
That's great. Okay, so can you tell me a little bit about what's going on currently and what you have upcoming in 2012?
Okay. Currently, what's going on right now, I actually just got cast yesterday in a short film.
Congratulations.
And he has a lead role, so that's going to be filmed in January. And I'm working on a sci-fi western called Six Gun Savior. So I'm producing it, I'm one of the co-stars in it, and that's also going to be filming in January. So it's going to be really fun, and really looking forward to all that.
That title is really interesting. It's a sci-fi western.
It's a supernatural western. I know.
Is that new in the entertainment industry? Supernatural? Is that a new title?
I don't think so. It's been around.
Okay. It's new to me. Well, that sounds really fun. So that's going to be a full feature film?
Mm-hmm.
And you're producing. So now you're getting into producing. That's really exciting. Do you like producing better than acting, or what do you like better?
I really love acting, and it's what I do, and it's amazing, it's so much fun, and I think producing is good for people if they have the opportunity to get into it, and it helps you see a different side of the industry that you would never see normally.
Yeah, exactly. It gives you a little bit more creative power, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. Can you tell me a little bit about your character that you're playing in that film?
Okay. Yeah, my character is Kyle Hawk Hawkins, and he is a very, not over the top, but he's a very forward, very, high, very fun, I don't want to say angry, but he has a lot of fun. You have to really, his arc is, he's got a really nice arc through the story progressing, and he really starts out as this show-off, know-it-all kind of like, oh, I'm the best, oh, you just, basically, literally, you just saved my life, but I'm gonna shoot you anyway because I don't like you.
Oh, wow.
And then he turns into this really nice, really caring guy, and it's pretty cool. Pretty cool transition.
Yeah, sounds like it has a lot of emotions, a lot of the level. It sounds like a great character. Very fun. So is this your second film that you're producing?
This is the second film. The first one I produced was a documentary called Never in Neverland, and that's about the AIDS epidemic in Swaziland and how there's not going to be very many adults left by 2020, and it's going to be all orphans. So it's a really amazing project, and it's really something that's got to be looked into. So we're really excited about that. It's in post-production right now. So
wonderful. And when that's finished, are you going to be submitting that to different film festivals?
Yeah, it's going to go all over the place. Sundance Hall. So.
Wonderful. Speaking of Sundance, Sundance is coming up next month. Are you in anything that's running there? Are you going to be partaking in any of the Sundance fun?
Not at the moment, but we're hoping to put a bunch of stuff in there for next year's Sundance.
Wonderful. Okay. Now your mother is also an actress, Lorraine Ziff. How's that being in this industry and also having a parent that's also an actor in the scene?
Yeah, she's really amazing. She started as an actress. She was an acting theater major in college. She went through, she's done a whole bunch of stuff. And it's really rewarding to be able to work with her. And it's fun. I mean, one of the movies that we just recently did over the summer was called Mansion of Blood. And I got to play her son. And it's really fun because it's acting, but then it's just so real. And it brings a new level to the production. So
yeah,
it's really fun to be able to work with her.
That was really fun being on set. That's a horror film, right? So
yeah.
I bet there was all sorts of crazy stuff going on set.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of crazy stuff. There was ghosts, demons, and witches, mummy, some really fun stuff. And that's going to be a really good project.
Wonderful. So you played her son in the film. Can you tell me a little bit about your character and a little bit about her character and how your character is played in the film?
Yeah, so the film is Mansion of Blood, and I was her son, and my father was played by Robert Picardo, and he's an amazing guy. And our family basically goes through, without giving too much of the plot away, because we're it's a nice surprise for everybody, basically goes through, and a lot of people are getting killed, and my character is kind of oblivious to the fact that everybody's getting killed, and he's just kind of partying, having a really good time, and then he finds out all these people are being killed, and he's like, whoa, what's going on? And gets all scared, but it's really fun.
Now, where does your mom's character come into play?
She's one of the main characters, but don't want to give it away. She's got a really nice part in there. So.
Sounds fun. So Mansion of Blood.
Mansion of Blood.
Coming up next year. Wonderful. So we would like to know a little bit about your personal life, if possible.
All right.
Just for your fans out there. Can you tell us a little bit about when you're not acting, what you do in your personal life?
Okay. I really enjoy lots of music. I play guitar, bass, saxophone, a little bit of piano. Lot of fun with that. I'm attempting to write, it's not really going too well. lots of reading. I love music and racing also. I love cars, motorcycles, all that. I love to race, drag racing, track racing. It's so much fun.
That sounds really fun.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Okay, so a large amount of our readers are female. And for all those fans out there that are female, we would like to know if you're single.
I have many female friends, but yes, I am single.
There you go, ladies. He's single. We have it officially on the record for you. Okay. And I would like to know, last but not least, if you weren't acting and if you weren't in this industry, what would you be doing with your life?
Okay. One of my other passions, in addition to acting, is I really enjoy designing things, like building, designing, all that stuff. So engineering, actually, I would really, in a different life, I would really like to be an engineer and really, really go through all that.
What intrigues you about engineering?
I don't know, I just really like how things work. Just even as a kid, I would always take things apart, put things together, really just fix stuff. It's really fun.
That's cool, just kind of making,
just tinkering with things, yeah.
Currently,
in addition to all that stuff, I'm writing a movie with one of my friends who's a film student. We're really, really working on it, and it's going to be a really cool project. I don't want to give too much away, but it's a lot of not like, it's a lot of like growing up and dealing with your own problems, and it's a little bit of fantasy sci-fi in there, so it's really cool, and that's gonna be a really fun project. We're hoping to finish the script at the end of the month, actually.
That sounds really fun. You have a lot of sci-fi projects coming up. Do you have some experience with like an alien in your life somewhere?
No.
Okay.
No.
Just double checking.
No alien abductions.
Okay.
No.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much for coming out and speaking with us today.
Thank you.
We really look forward to your upcoming projects. So I heard that you were on Conan O'Brien when you were what?
Little kid, yeah.
Little kid, yeah. Can you tell us about that?
All right, yeah, I was 10 years old. I was on Conan. I auditioned, they called my agent, I got the role, I came in, they didn't tell me what I was doing. So I get there and they bring me backstage and they dress me up in this kind of dorky looking stuff, a sweater vest, a tie, like khakis, and they put these big glasses on me. And I didn't need glasses and they were prescription, so my eyes were kind of bugging out a little bit. It was really funny. And then they give me a script and I'm learning, like, oh, this is so funny. So this little kid, and it's Christmas episode, and Conan's dressed up as Santa, and he says, what do you want for Christmas? And I say, I want to know what I'm going to be when I grow up. So he says, all right, well, Matthew, we've got, right here, we've got a video of what you're going to be. So then they have this guy who's maybe 25, maybe 30, and dressed up, same clothing as me, a little bit bigger, obviously, same exact glasses. And he does, because Conan used to do his whole song and dance intro, and they did the exact same thing, and it says, Late Night with Matthew Ziff. And he does this whole thing, and it's really funny. And then it flashes back to us, and it's like, so Matthew, what do you think? And I'm like, I say to Conan, what a loser I'm gonna be, and I run off stage crying. And everybody starts cracking up, and it wasn't like, nobody was there for the rehearsal, none of the band, so Mabama from the band, still on the show, stood there. That was the year 2000 Elf, and he stands there just cracking up, and then Conan looks at him, he's like, I thought that was funny, huh? And he's like, yeah, it just keeps laughing, so.
That is a wonderful story.
So, it's now 10 years ago, or yeah, now 10 years ago that I was on that episode. It's actually coming up. It was December 21st, I think.
Your tenure.
It's coming up.
Gotta get back on there.
Conan, I want my seat back. You promised me. I want my seat, Conan.
He's coming for you, Conan, so watch out. That is really exciting to be on such a huge talk show at such a young age. I mean, were you nervous when you came out in that outfit and you saw all these people? I mean, how was that experience for you? You must have been excited to be there.
Yeah, I was a bit nervous, but it was really fun. And overall, I had a really great time.
And something really fun to look back on, too.
Exactly, yeah.
And now something really fun to look forward to getting back on, too.
Exactly.
What a great experience. Well, thank you so much for coming out today for Magic Image Hollywood Magazine. And good luck.
Thank you.
Or in the entertainment industry, you should say. Break a leg.